Now we're up to our request and dedication. This one's from a 32-year-old woman named Joni in Alberta, Canada. And here's what she writes. Dear Casey, my story is a little different. January 11th, 1973 was the date. I was 16 at the time. In fact, it was my birthday. I got up all excited, thinking like a normal 16-year-old that my presents would be waiting for me before I went to school. I had asked for a pair of leather boots or a midi coat that I wanted desperately because all my friends had one. But there weren't any presents. Naturally, I was upset, so I stormed out of the house. My dad came out behind me calling my name. I don't know to this day what possessed me to do this, but I turned around with tears streaming down my face. I shouted to him to drop dead, and I just turned around and walked away. After school, I came home, and there was my father being taken away in an ambulance. He had had a major heart attack. My mom made me go to school the next day. I couldn't go to classes. I just sat in the girls' washroom all morning crying. Then it happened. My name came over the PA system. Would I please report to the office immediately? I got this huge lump in my throat. I thought I'd choke. Casey, that was the longest walk of my life from that washroom to the office. As I rounded the corner, I saw the principal, my dad's best friend, and my uncle standing there. No words were spoken. There was no need for any. We drove to my house. All I could think of was, Daddy, I didn't mean it. I went to my room to be alone, and my heart just stopped. Sitting there on the bed were two big boxes, beautifully wrapped with a card attached that read, Happy Birthday, Sweet 16. Love, Mom and Dad. It was my coat and boots. I was completely broken. I never got a chance to tell my dad that I was sorry. I tell you, Casey, these feelings of guilt are as strong today as they were 16 years ago. So would you please play The Living Years by Mike and the Mechanics and dedicate it to my father? I know in my heart that he'll hear it. I love you, Daddy. I'm sorry. Yours truly, Joni. Joni, here's your request and dedication.
Come beating on your door. I know that I'm a prisoner to all my father held so dear. I know that I'm a hostage to all his hopes and fears. I just wish I could have told him in the living years.
Say
it loud. Say it loud.
I'm sure I heard his echo in my baby's newborn tears. I just wish I could have told him in the living years. So say, say, say it loud.
Say it clear.
Oh, say it clear.
Living Years, a hit from Mike and the Mechanics earlier this year, and a request and dedication from Joni in Canada to her father.